Right? And they start talking about, you know, claiming things. You know, we claim this, we claim that, we claim that. And then they lose connection that those things are on the land. Mm-hmm. Why just deal with the land instead of dealing with, you know what I mean? So just like with this, why not deal with the principles that make the thing up, mm-hmm. opposed to dealing with what is presented as the thing?
Mm-hmm.
Right? The philosophy of the ancient prophets is the main initiative in the compilation of the Quran. No thoughts of propaganda enter this work, as has been the case of many former religious works, such as the Bible and other books of creed. Right? So he's telling you that propaganda has entered other books of creed, including the Bible.
Change it up.
And then remember that during this time was time Christianity was, you know what I mean, prominent amongst our people. So he had to put out certain things, Quran, saying Jesus and all this type of stuff. But at the same time, talking against the Bible to get these people to change their position. Because where they were at clearly wasn't right and exact where they were at, right? They were way off where they were supposed to be. The sole purpose of the Prophet in giving such a message to the world is to save fallen humanity. When a compiler attempts to inject propaganda into a work of this kind, there arises a need to cover the true text in order to prevent a clash with the truth and ideas involved in such propaganda. The sole purpose of the Prophet is in giving such a message to the world is to save fallen humanity. When the compiler attempts to inject propaganda into a work of this kind, there arises a need to cover the true text in order to prevent a clash with the truth and ideas involved in such propaganda. So the only reason that they put the propaganda in there, the only reason for putting the propaganda in is because they realize that the truth is going to clash with the propaganda, mm-hmm. right? And they have to make sure that the propaganda stands out more than the truth stands out. So they take these truth books and put propaganda in it because they know that's what the people's mentality is trained to go for, mm-hmm. right? You know, it's just like with you know, our people, history with our people, and them having the, you know, the slave ship mentality. And then they forget the whole thing about the 400 years that we're talking about. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? That the government's only been here, so-called government's only been here 200 years, mm-hmm. but you're saying that they enslaved you for 400. Yeah. But that's a contradiction.
Yeah.
But instead of correct themselves because they realize, oh, we got caught in the lie or whatever like that. Yeah. We've been caught following propaganda. Mm-hmm. They say, oh, we don't know what we're talking about. And then they start bringing up stuff about Moors enslaving people or whatever like that to divert attention from the fact that we caught them pushing the propaganda mm-hmm. as what history is. When that's not history, that's propaganda that they're yeah. presenting.
Yeah.
They're not presenting historical facts. They're presenting propaganda. They're presenting reconstruction of history information that they've been given by their black leaders under the guise of that's their history. When majority of that stuff has nothing to do with them. Former works of this kind have either hindered or helped the nations proportionately to the adherence to the truth as the original purpose of keeping the ignorant in such a state. It is hard to resist the temptation to use this medium for gain. Hence, many of the former treaties on works of this kind have been the means to foster ideas of the unscrupulous wherein they desire to use religious influence for gain. The many secrets known to the Prophet that could be used for the salvation of the nation were either left out or colored to an extent that their meaning was made void. Such is not the case with this edition of the Quran. All the secrets of the ages known to man were put into this work. All the secrets of the ages known to man. Right, so this is why Juwali could say, I took away all the secrets. Because all the secrets known to man, not the secrets that man doesn't know, all the secrets that man knows was compiled and put into this work called Holy Quran of the Modern Science Temple of America. All the secrets. And then when we read it, we see the secrets there. That
missing pieces.
Right, that were meant to be used for the salvation of the nation. And all they need is that. That's why he held that up. And the 101 questionnaire. Yeah.
Well, he was so brilliant that he used Jesus, knowing that our people is so fixated on it, on that character. Mm-hmm. So he used him as, you know what I mean, as the light, as the truth. Like
right.
The missing parts that the European Christianity didn't teach us, or didn't teach them. So, that's just the divine power.
Right. Now also too, like you know, we're gonna get the people with the plagiarism and whatever like that. You know, I mean, he copied this, he copied that, or whatever, right? You know, majority of those people who have issues with the Quran haven't even read it.
Exactly.
Right? To know what's in there. And anybody with common sense reads the Quran, they will see for themselves that, hold on a second, there's something different about this book. You know what I mean? And also too, what you're saying, like with you know, him putting Jesus in there and stuff like that. If somebody really loves Jesus or whatever, like they see that, they proclaim their nationality tomorrow.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Not gonna be in denial. Oh, well, I don't know. This might not be.
Exactly.
They're going with it.
Yeah.
Just because it says that name in there, that they love so much, and they're gonna go here, do that, do this for Jesus or whatever, and then you have this individual coming and he's telling them that Jesus was descendant of Moabites.
Mm-hmm.
So if Jesus is a Moor, that means you're a Moor too.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not gonna jump on board. Why wouldn't they jump on board?
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Exactly. And again, this is why when we you know, introduce Noble Juwali's literature to people, we have to do this, like break it down,
yeah,
so people could understand
easier. The
impact that his information is supposed to have on our people and the impact that it did have on the people back then. And those people were slaves, they didn't have computer and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So the people today that get this, when this comes to them, they should be on this like...
Yeah. Monday, what's Monday? The Quincy I went to, because this guy was waiting for me to show me a car, Turkish car.
Yeah.
I didn't even know it was Turkish because it's an Italian friend sent. When he come, another Italian come to take stuff from his car that was already in the shop.
Yeah.
You see my face, say, your hat. What's about this hat?
He's from Turkey?
No.
Oh, that's the other
Italian
one.
Italian.
Oh, that's okay. Yeah.
So the Turkish one was there too. So then I explained to him what it was. Then he leave. The Turkish one turned to me and said, my grandfather used to be a one. They don't know history. You know they're
crazy. Yeah, like, get out of here.
You know they don't know history.
You know they
my
know
grandfather
that.
Used
yeah,
to be one.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you see. Some people know it and some of us don't know what's going
on. Right. Right. And then even on that level,
mm-hmm.
just like with them talking about the Moroccans don't approve
mm-hmm.
of the Moors saying they're Moroccan or using the flag because that's their stuff.
Yeah.
Then we have the Turks now.
Yeah.
Backing up the fact that, yeah, mm-hmm. we have authority to wear this.
Yeah.
Because he's saying, well, my granddad used to wear one, and he wasn't on some, well, that's our stuff from Turkey and all that. You can't wear that.
Because he's telling me know that I know what right. I know myself.
Yeah, you know
he
yourself.
Don't even know
exactly.
What I even have something to say on that too. When I was at the dollar store just yesterday, and I was in line, and this lady, she looked Guyanese, and she was like, oh, my father used to wear this when back home. When, you know, and he was like saying, oh, I haven't seen,
I haven't seen it in so long.
Like,
yeah.
So I said, well, you know, I explained to her, this is my national headdress and that, you know, I know myself. She goes, I know.
I know you know yourself.
Yeah.
Right? Just like one of the Moors posted a picture on Facebook about some Hindustanis. He's walking, actually two stories like this. He's walking, Hindustani brother ran up on him, like, yo, I need to get a picture of you wearing the fez so I can send it back home. Like, I want to be in a picture with you.
Mm-hmm.
So I can send this picture back home.
So they can see what?
So they can see, we'll see what, you know what I mean? They're gonna send a picture all the way back home to India or whatever of dark-skinned individual wearing a fez, and then our people are gonna say that we don't know what's up, that they're not getting down with this, they're gonna get down with all the other stuff out there.
Yeah, it's like,
but then Turkish, Hindustani, sister Kalafia right now, she's in India right now. Went to India, she was at Taj Mahal, right? She said that, okay, she got a picture with one group of ladies because they straight asked, like, you know, could we take a picture with you or whatever like that, right? Same thing, because she had a turban and all that stuff, and they're like, that's not normal.
Never seen.
Like, we don't see people who look like you wearing turban. You know, and then you know that it's not just some, you know, Rasta, just wrap your head. Like, there's something to how yours is that distinguishes you, right? She said that 80% of the people there, when they see, they do the whisper and point and, you know what I mean? Like, you know, follow a little bit, like walk behind her, see where she's going or whatever like that, because it's just like what they were saying, like, I haven't seen that in so long. Like, somebody who looks like you, actually wearing a fez or wearing a turban, like, they must know something.
Yeah.
These people must have some type of information.
Rotten language, all people.
That the average people who look like them don't have. Let me get a picture of this to send this back home.
Remember what the guy did with my thing, my car? Remember the call them the Bin Laden, what do you call them?
Taliban?
What do you call it? Afghan.
Afghanistan.
Young boy in the parts place. He said, man, can I take a picture of it? It means he don't want to go tell his friend about it.
Yeah, he wants to show.
Have
something to show.
He asked me, I said, you're never going to put it on the internet. I said, no, I just wanted to show him.
Yeah.
I never wanted to. It's
just our people.
Only us. The secrets known only to the Magi are here revealed. The reading of the stars. Right? The reading of the stars. So this is what's in the Quran. Is what he said, right?